Children, good morning. Today we will start the chapter 8 and the topic is quadrilateral. So first of all, we should know what is quadrilateral. You know that in the earlier classes already you have studied the types of polygons. So this is the one type of polygon that is called quadrilateral. A polygon bounded with four line segments is called a quadrilateral. Four line segments are AB, you can see the picture, AB, BC, CD and DA. Okay, so this is the picture bounded with four line segments, or you can say four straight lines. Okay, so that's why this picture is called quadrilateral. And in this quadrilateral, what do we find? The things are, first of all, you can see the vertices. Okay, the vertices means the initial point of two arms. The initial point of two arms, that is called vertices. Corner, used to say corner, that is called vertices. Whether the two arms meet, that point is called vertices. So this A, B, C and D, these points are vertices. Understand? And angles, the initial point of two rays form angles. So angles are angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. You know, these angles we can denote by three letters also. So how do we show the angles in another way? How can we name? The another way is, suppose this angle A, I have denoted it, I have named this angle by single letter, capital A. Okay, you can see here. But if you want to name it by three letters, then what will be the three letter of this angle A? So you have to see this initial point. For this initial point, which two rays are there? Means for this point, you can see AD and AB are the arms which meet in this point A. The initial point of AD and AB is A. So this angle will be named by DAB or BAD. Why? In both ways you can name. But this initial point should be in middle. Okay? Middle means you can say DAB. So A is in middle between the two letters D and B. Clear? Now this angle ABC, angle B will be named as ABC. Angle C will be named as BCD, BCD or DCB. In any way you can take. Okay, angle D will be named as ADC or CDA. Okay, angle ADC. So these are the another way. And if you want to name it by numbers or putting another letters, so sometimes we put inside the angle 1, sometimes we put a small a, sometimes we put x. No, we put. So by putting these numbers you can name the angle. And that time what will be, suppose you want to put here angle 1, this is 2, this is 3 and this is 4. So what will be the name of that angle? Angle 1, angle 2, angle 3 and angle 4. So sometime according to need, when we prove the theorems or something, you know, we solve the problems related to these quadrilaterals or triangles, so we put the numbers, we suppose the numbers by 1, 2, 3, 4, by x, y, z, by small letter a, b, c, d. Now, so these are. After that, now you understood the angles. After that, the arms. Arms are, means sides. The sides are AB, BC, CD and DB or AD. AB, you can say AB, otherwise BA can be, the length is same. From any side, if you take the name, from suppose this side you are taking AB, 5 cm, then what will be the BA? 5 cm only? Okay, 5 cm only, no direct, after changing the direction, length will not change. length will be the same. After that, BC, CD, and DA. These are the sides, arms. After that, what do we see? Sometimes we listen in adjacent angles. What are adjacent angles? So adjacent angle means the angle, adjacent angle is between two arms. Suppose angle A is there, and angle A and angle B is there, and these two angles is common with the arm AB. For this angle, two angles, the common arm is AB. So these two angles are called adjacent angles. Means two angles are said to be adjacent angles which have a common arm. Means AB is the common arm for which angles? Angle A and angle B. Because when you name angle A, then you write DAB, and when you name angle B, then you write ABC. In both the cases, you see AB is common. So that's why angle A and angle B, both angles are adjacent angles. For which arm? For AB. So like that, how many adjacent angles you see? Angle A and angle B, one pair we see there. After that, angle B and angle C also will be adjacent. Why? Because BC is common for angle B and angle C. So here another pair we see, angle B and angle C. After that, third pair we see, angle C and angle D, angle C and angle D. And fourth pair we see, angle D and angle A, angle D and angle A. These are adjacent angles. So if there are adjacent angles, obviously there will be adjacent sides also. So in just opposite of this adjacent angles, opposite of adjacent angles is what? In adjacent angles, one arm was common. In adjacent sides, one angle will be common. So that is only. So adjacent sides AB and BC are adjacent sides. Why? Because B is common for both the sides. Now adjacent sides are AB and BC, one pair AB and BC, these two sides are adjacent sides. So another pair is also there for C, BC and CD. After that, for D, CD and DA, this is the pair CD and DA. After that, for A, DA and AB, DA and AB. So these are adjacent sides. Sometimes we face opposite angles and opposite sides. So opposite angles. So opposite angles means, suppose I am standing here. So front of me, who is standing, that person will be called opposite person. Opposite to me, that is called front of me, that is called opposite to me. So front of this angle is C. So opposite angle of A will be angle C, opposite angle of B will be angle D, opposite angle of D will be angle B, opposite angle C will be angle A. Understand? So these are called opposite, means just standing facing each other, that is called opposite. Facing each other, that is called opposite. So opposite angles are angle A, angle C, angle B, and angle D. These are opposite angles. After that, opposite sides also will be there. I told facing each other, opposite sides. So what are opposite sides? AB, DC. AB and DC, these are opposite sides. And BC, AD, these are opposite sides. BC, AD, these are opposite sides. Understand? So these all things we find in a quadrilateral. So many things are there, and we should know when you will go through the property, when you will go through the problems related to this property, related to quadrilateral, then there you will face these all things, and that time what will be, just you will do, but the things will not come, the right things will not come in your mind. Yes, so we should know these all things. After that, more things are also there. The more things are what? Diagonals. We did not discuss about this. Diagonal means the line segment which join the opposite vertices. Opposite vertices means A, opposite of A is C, and opposite of B is D. So joining A to C, that is, that line segment is called diagonal. Joining B to D, that is called diagonal. Means in a quadrilateral, one pair of diagonals are there. Now, diagonals. Diagonals AC and BD. These two line segments are diagonals. Okay? Understand? Okay? So now you see the types of quadrilateral. Number one, rectangle. Rectangle, you see the diagram, this is rectangle, and thus I am naming this rectangle A, B, C, D. Now, what are the special properties of this rectangle? How will know this rectangle? You know that in this world, around our surroundings, in our surroundings, we see the things, and we see the things and we define the things according to their properties. Yes or no? Suppose Ram and Shyam, two students are there, then we know the Ram with his quality and we know Shyam with his quality. Both persons have the different quality. So like that, here types of quadrilaterals. So many types of quadrilaterals are there, and we know the each of the quadrilaterals according to their properties. So this is a rectangle. This rectangle is also known according to its property. So what are the properties? Number one, first of all, each angle of rectangle is 90 degree. You know that opposite sides are parallel and equal. So we'll start writing. First property will be two pairs. How many pairs of opposite sides are there? Two pairs. One pair is this one, and this is the another pair. One and two. So two pairs of opposite sides are parallel and equal. This is the first property of rectangle. Two pairs of opposite sides are parallel and equal. Parallel and equal. Parallel and single cut, it means equal, so equal. Parallel and equal. Another, number two, each of the angles is 90 degree or right angle. In the box, in the bracket, write right angle. Each of the angle is right angle. Diagonals are equal. Diagonals are equal. Third point. Diagonals are equal and bisect each other. Diagonals are equal and bisect each other. Okay, you can see here, see the diagram. This AC and BD both are diagonals and they bisect. Bisect means dividing equally. Dividing into two parts equally, equally dividing. So suppose they intersect each other at O, means AO here, ए ओ इक्वल टू ओ सी एंड बी ओ इक्वल टू ओ डी दिस इज मीन्स डायगोनल्स बाइसेक्ट ईच अदर. सपोज आई टोल्ड यू डायगोनल्स ऑफ रेक्टेंगल आर इक्वल एंड बाइसेक्ट ईच अदर इक्वल. सपोज दिस डायगोनल्स 8 सेंटीमीटर सो बी डी ऑल्सो विल बी 8 सेंटीमीटर एंड दे बाइसेक्ट ईच अदर मीन्स ईच ऑफ द पार्ट विल बी 4 सेंटीमीटर. Diagonals bisect each other. So this is the special property of rectangle. And from other quadrilateral, how this is different? How the rectangle is different from other quadrilateral? So let's see another type of quadrilateral is square. Another type of quadrilateral is square. A, B, C, D. This is also named A, B, C, D. And first of all, we should know what are the special properties of this quadrilateral, this square. All sides are equal. Number one property, all sides are equal. Okay? Number two will be opposite sides are parallel. Okay, and number three, diagonals are equal and bisect each other at right angle. Diagonals are equal and bisect each other at right angle. ABCD is square and AC and BD are diagonals and they bisect each other at right angle. Right angle is 90 degree. Diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree. Okay. After that, each of the angle is right angle 90 degree. Each of the angle is 90 degree. Understand? Each of the angle is 90 degree. Okay. Opposite sides are parallel, you have written?
Yes, sir.
So, all the property of this rectangle, all the property of this rectangle, do we find in this quadrilateral square? All the property of rectangle do we find in this quadrilateral?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So that's why we say a square can be a rectangle, but all the property of square we do not find in a rectangle. So that's why we say a rectangle cannot be a square. So write this point. A square can be a rectangle, but a rectangle cannot be a square. No. A rectangle can be a square can be a rectangle, but a rectangle cannot be a square. You see that? Understand?
Yes, sir.
Because all the property of this square means this rectangle we find in this. Each of the angle is 90 degree. So here, each of the angle is 90 degree. All opposite sides are parallel and equal. So opposite sides are parallel and equal. Now, diagonal bisect each other. The square has more property than this rectangle, but all the property of this rectangle we find in this square. So that's why a square is a rectangle, but a rectangle is not a square. Okay.